Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now, in this video, we are going to talk about completion handlers and how you can use them in your code. So let's just jump right into it. Now, go ahead and click the link down below and you will find the resources, basically the link to my GitHub repository there. And it is called completion handlers example, and make sure you clone or download the starter project. And once you do that, you will be able to see something like this. Well, basically you will not have the pods and the pod file log, only the pod file. Now you want to update the pod file, so go ahead and open up terminal here. Let me make that a little bit bigger so you may see. Type in cd and a space. Just grab and drop the root folder of the project, hit return and type in pod update. Okay, now this will update all of the pods, including mine, and that is tiny constraints. Let me just show you what this pod file is all about. It's tiny constraints to constrain our views. Now, what is this till it is updating? We will talk about what this starter project is about. Well, we have a root view controller that is added to our navigation stack, and all of that is added to our Windows root view controller. Basically, we are starting off with this root view controller, and we have our I believe this popped up because the update is ready. Yes, indeed it is. Okay, so let us just go here and talk about the dispatch queue helper. If you haven't seen my dispatch queue or threading video, it is the previous one. Go ahead and take a look at it and you will understand about grant center dispatch. Okay, now let me just show you what this root view controller does. Basically, we have here a button, a label, and we are setting it up and constraining it to our view controller, and we are grabbing the data from a database. We are basically simulating a background fetch. No, we are simulating the delay of the background fetch, and we are getting back a result of 1, and we are coming back to our main thread and displaying this result in the labels text. Okay, now that is the starter project. Now, what do we want to do? What and how this all comes to completion handlers? Well, let's say that you don't want to use massive view controllers, and I know you don't. Now, you want to have this grab data from database somewhere else on your project. So let us just take this grab data from database and add it to, let's say, a services class. So let's create a new file here, and I will call this service. Okay, let's import UI kit just in case, and let's name this service, and it will not have any superclass, but we will have inside here this grab data from a database. Let's just simply copy it out. Let's cut it out. Okay, and let's add this one here. And to be able to call this grab data from database, this function needs to be static. Okay, so now we want to grab data from database. Let's just hit command B and we will see the errors. First of all, we have some error in the service, and that is the label cannot be found, and we have this use of unresolved identifier. We basically cannot see grab data from database. Let's handle the first one, the easiest one, and that is type in here service dot and grab data from database. So now we do know, but how to manage this label? Now, what we could do is add in the label, but yeah, that is kind of complicated. What we need is a completion handler. Now, most probably you did see some completion handlers, like when you presented a view controller and it says completion, you always said that nil, well, basically always, not always, but it is what we do most of the time. But you could add in here and there anything in the completion. So let's create a completion. So I'm going to first create the completion and then I'm going to talk about it. So let's type in here completion. And let's create a basic completion for now. Okay, add in two parentheses here and an arrow and another parentheses. Okay, let's hit a command build again. We get the same errors. Plus we have a missing argument for parameters. So let's delete some letters here and select this completion. And as you can see, we have some completion, hit return again. And now we can add in some code, what we do want to have once we finish grabbing our data. Okay, so what we want to do is go into service and take this self.label.text out of there. So let's cut that out and paste that in. It's still not quite good enough, but it's a good point to take this label where it actually is. Okay, now back to the service. Now we do get the result of one. You want to dispatch queue to the main thread, and go ahead and take a look at the previous video if you don't know what I'm talking about here. And what we want to do is complete here. So complete, completion, and that's it. We have our result, and then we can, of course, we need to have, I believe we need to, yeah, we need to fix escaping. Okay. And we should get a result. Well, we should get a completion after those 3 seconds. We don't have the result just yet, only here. We cannot, and I will show you how to push the result to our view controller here. So for now, let's just delete this result here. We are just setting result. So let's just hit command B and see if everything is okay. Build has succeeded. Now let's build and run and see what actually happens. And finally, in the last part of the tutorial, we are going to transfer the data and you will see why that is so important. So let's tap on fetch data from server. 1, 2, 3 seconds has gone, and the result, of course, just the result is added as the text. So we don't have the result, but we should have it. So let's go and fix that. Going back into the service file, and let's add in here in the completion, let's say we want to have underscore result, and this will be of type int because we do know that the result is an integer. Now we need to change the completion, and the completion is the result. Great. Now this is how we add in this data. So let's grab it in the root view controller, and yeah, we need to refactor this. So let's just delete this database. I believe we need to hit a command B so Xcode realizes that there have been changes in the code. So yeah, completion with an integer. Let's hit return again. And let's say result. Let's add this result. And self.label.text equals to result. And let's end there the result. Okay, and this should be it, but we are going to add in some tweaking and conveniences so you can enjoy your code better. So let's test this out. This should work. 1, 2, 3. Result equals 1. Yeah, and that's it for completion handlers. Now I want to show you a few tricks that you might want to use with these completion handlers. First of all, when you want to fetch some data, that data isn't always there. It could be nil. So under the result, let's set this to optional. That is great. Now we will have an error. Let's hit command B and we will have let's go to our root view controller. Here, string interpolation produces debug description and so on. The main idea is that now here under result, we get an optional. So we need to guard let unwrap it. So what we want to basically do here, guard let result equals result, else we want to return. Maybe you want to print out some statements, but no, we are just going to return for now. So let's hit Command B now, and we should see this error go away, because now we can return even a nil. So let me just type in here print and add in here that. Okay, and now if we go to the services, let's just build and run for now. Okay, and we should see the same thing with optional. And there we go. 1, 2, 3. There we have our result. Great. So let's add in here a nil. Okay. And let's build and run. Of course, the result isn't used. Yeah, no matter. Let's just say that the nil has been fetched, so no data. And we should see here, waiting for result, nothing happened, and it says failed to fetch result. Great. Now, the next thing that you want to do is, let's just make this back to result there. And the next thing that you want to do is go back to root view controller, and let's just start typing this again. So service dot grab data from database, and you can see that here we have an integer. You don't really know what you are expecting back. Of course, this is an int and it's an optional int, but what exactly is that? Is that a result or a fetch? What is it? So we want to change that. Let's just delete this, go back to services, and we want to have here something like, let's say, Rebeloper result or something like that, that is really conveys what you are getting back. So for that, of course, we can get a Rebeloper result back. Of course, you can have your models, but for now, let it be of int. So we are going to use a type alias, and it will be a Rebeloper result, and the type expression integer as an int. So we can simply use this as the Rebeloper result. Okay, so when it is basically an int, you are returning an int, and that is why this succeeds. Okay, so now when we go back to our root view controller, let's hit Command B so we can do get the completion. So let's type in service dot grab date from database. Let me just scroll that up, and you can see grab from database, and you can see the completion has a Rebeloper result. So let's hit on that and again return, and you can see that it is a Rebeloper result. So it is more explicit. Okay, now that is it for completion handlers. Now that is basically what you need to know about completion handler, and it covers 99% of all the use cases that you can have in your code. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell, of course. And as always, I will see you in the next one.